Hello guys, welcome back to my channel VFX Expert. So guys, in this today's class we are going to see 3D stabilization or roto using 3D stabilization in Nuke. So here in our previous part 1 I have replaced this screen using projection and point cloud generator here. So here there were original plate here, then after this I have used projection and just I have replaced this screen, this one here. So you can see this one. So now here we can see this one. Then after this finally I have used roto for this character. So this is our character roto output here. Then finally I have composed this character roto on top of this screen composite here. So this is our final output here. So here guys, in this today's class we are going to see how we can easily create a roto for this character using 3D stabilization in Nuke, because in our previous part 1 simply I have used this roto output here. But in this today's class we are going to see how we can create a roto for this character using 3D stabilization in Nuke. So guys, before starting this part, please watch my part 1 of this video. So link I have given in descriptions. So now just I am going to see how we can easily create a roto using 3D stabilization in Nuke. So for creating a roto for this character, simply if you want you can just take a direct roto node, then just simply connect this footage, then select this one, press 1 and just double click here and just create a shape according to requirement. So this is just only for explanation. Then you can just create a shape, then after this you can animate according to this character movement. So like this, just we have to create a roto for this character here. But this is a little bit difficult here because this character is moving. So you can see here. So how we can easily create a roto for this character using 3D stabilizations here. So now just delete this one here. So now first we have to create a card at this character positions here. So for this, just first take a card. So press tab and just take a card. Then we have to take a scene node and just connect this card with our this scene. Then connect this camera with our this scene also here. Now select this scene and press 1 here. Now we are inside of a new 3D view here and this is our card here. So here first we have to place this card at this character position here. So for this here I have created this point cloud generated node. So in our part 1 I have created this one here. So simply what we have to do, just define properties 2 here. So at a time 2 node properties we can display here. Now just double click on this point cloud generator and also double click on this card here. Now select this scene and press 1 here. Now we are inside new 3D view here. So here we can see this is our character positions here. So now we have to move this card at this character position. Then double click on this card and just we have to place it here. So here simply just I have placed over this card at this character positions here. Then after this we have to take a project 3D node. So press tab and just take a project 3D node. Then after this, in this camera input we have to connect our original camera, this animated camera. Then in this image input we have to connect our original plate. So just we have to connect it here, hold control and just click it here. So remember this one, here I am using this original video, not any still images. Okay, so here original plate just I am using for 3D stabilization here. Then after this, so just connect it here. Then we have to take a scale line render. So press tab and just take a scale line render node. Then here in scale line render we have to connect this scene with our this scene input. Then for this VG I am going to take a constant. Even if you want you can also take a reformat node according to our original footage frame size here. So press tab and just take a constant and just connect it here and double click on this constant and just select format, which is 1920x1080. Then we have to select our frame where easily we can create our roto for this character. So here at frame 100 easily we can create a roto for this character here. Then take a frame hold node. So here we have to connect this frame hold node with our this original camera. Then double click on this frame hold node and just we have to type it here frame, where easily we can create our roto. Then finally we have to connect this scale line render camera with our this static camera. Now hold control and just break it here. Now just select this scale line render and press 1 here. Now just if you will move, so you will see here this footage has stabilized at this position here. Now just play and check here. So now guys, if you will see here, this footage or this character has stabilized at this position here. So you can see this is rotating, but this is not moving from here to here like as before here, because here I have stabilized this footage at this positions here. But guys, suppose if you will see here, we are getting this actually cropping area here. So you can adjust this card size. So just double click on this card and just you can adjust this card size according to your requirements here. So now just we can increase it here. So just maximum area we have to cover. Now this is looking good here because entire plate we are stabilizing at this positions here. Then after this I am going to start create a roto for this character, because we have to replace this screen. So only this portion just we have to focus. So at frame 100 just I am going to create a save for this character. Then after this scale line render, we can take a roto node. So press O and just connect it here. Now select this one, press 1, then double click on this roto and just create a save. So here just only for explanation, just I am going to create a save. Then you can create a multi-shape according to your this object or character here. Maybe ear for different shape, head for different shape, and this for different shapes. So here guys, different shapes you can create according to your objects or footage here. Now here just I am going to create a save. So just we can select and just create a save just only for head here. So now here just I have created a roto shape for this character. Then after this just we have to move our plate and just we have to check this is following or not. So just a little bit we have to adjust, because here I have stabilized this character at this position here. So just little bit we have to adjust it here. Then after this is not interacting with our this screen. Then if you want, you can just animate this opacity. So right click on this opacity and just click on set key here. Then in our previous frame, just make it 0 here. So before this frame, roto will not work here. So only inside this area roto will work. So if you want to check your alpha channel, now press A. But guys, now if you will see here, we are not getting any alpha here. So what we can do? So after this scan line render, we have to use a shuffle node here. And before this roto node, just we have to connect it here. Then select this roto node and press 1, and just we have to select this black output here, this one. Now we are getting alpha here. So alpha is important for roto. So if you are getting problem like this, then before roto you can use shuffle node. Now again press A here. So now here just I have created roto shape for this character here. So like this just you can create your all shapes according to this character here. So here guys, I have already created. So now just I am going to insert it here. So just we can take, this is our actually roto here. So simply Ctrl C copy and just we can easily paste it here. Ctrl V paste and just remove this roto and delete this one and just connect it here. So now just double click on this roto. So guys, here you can see these are our shapes for this character here. So here just I have created. Okay, then after this what we have to do, because here we are getting this alpha channel. So if you want, you can direct apply pre-mult node after this roto node. So press tab and just click on this pre-mult here. So we are getting this character output here. Then if you want a little bit smooth your edges, then after this roto, press B for blend node, double click here. Then in channel, we can select our this alpha channel and just we have to adjust this size here. So according to requirement, just you can adjust this. So okay, this is just sufficient for this one here. So here just I am getting this result here. But here this is actually our stabilized output. Now finally we have to reapply our camera motion on our this stabilized roto here. So for this what we have to do? So again same thing just we have to follow. So first we have to copy same card. So select this one, Ctrl C copy, then Ctrl V paste it here. And just take a Project 3D node here. So here in this camera, we have to use same static camera, which is at frame 100, this one. And this image input, just we have to connect with for this roto output here, this one here. Then finally, we have to project this roto output on our this same card here. So now just connect it here. Then after this, again, we have to take a scale and render. So just simply Ctrl C copy and paste. Now here what we have to do, so here for background we can use same constant, and this scene we have to connect with our this card, and this camera, now we have to connect with our original camera, which is our animated here. So remember this one, this original camera here. Now hold control and just place it here, and just place it here, so easily we can understand here. Now just select this one, press 1 here. So now guys, here we are getting this our original motion here, which is according to our this original plate here. So now if you will select this one, so here you can see this one. So same motion we are getting here after creating our this roto here. So same thing we are getting here. Then finally we can use this roto and we can do our final composting here. So this is our screen composting here. Then after this, what we can do, simply just take a merge node, press M. So this will be our background here, and this roto output will be our foreground here. Now select this one, press 1 here. So same thing we are getting here. So in our previous part, direct I have used this roto output. So here in this class, I have explained here how we can easily create a roto using 3D stabilization in Nuke here. Then after this roto node, if you want, you can also use a erode filter. So now just select this one, press 1. Now if you will press A, so we are getting this one here. Then after this, if you want, you can press Tab and just take a erode node here, this one. Then here in channel, we have to select this alpha. Then we can easily adjust our this roto here. Now just check our final output here. So simply we can select, press 1. Now again press A here. So if you will now just double click on this roto erode, so we can just adjust our these edges here. So here we can see this one. So like this, just you can also use erode filter and just you can adjust your roto edges here. Now this is looking good here. Just according to requirement, just we have to use this one here. Maybe this is sufficient here. So now guys, this is our final output here. So if you like this video, please watch, share, comment and subscribe my channel if you are still not subscribed my channel. So thanks for watching.